Welcome to Freed on Business. He grew up in South Florida, has been in business here since the early 90s, and has closed over $3 billion in deals. He's seen it all. He always has an opinion, and he's always ready to share it. Informed, entertaining, and connected, he has his finger on the pulse of South Florida's business community. He's Jim Freed, and this is Freed on Business.
Oh, we've got a great show for everybody today. I want to thank everybody for joining us today. We've got my good friend Jeffrey Glusman on. We're going to talk about his work in the art world and helping collectors monetize their art investment. We're also going to talk in the second half of the hour with Ed Cairo. Ed will talk about the new ways that he's getting people into their homes or helping them pull equity out of their homes to pay down their credit cards, something that's really popular right now. So while it seems that interest rates are at historic highs, they actually are at historic lows versus their 30-year historic numbers. So we have a real interesting show. We hope that you'll be here. We know that you'll learn something interesting that you can use today to help your life be better. And we'll start off with some information from our friends at Warren Henry. Mr. Mendoza, the show is yours. I'm just writing some notes down here on one of the real estate deals I'm doing, and I hope that you won't mind if my phone pops today, but we're in some hot negotiations on some closings we've got coming up. And I want to thank my friends at Warren Henry. They're the best. Larry's in, Eric Day, of course, Warren's in, all my friends over there, Maytel Stark, who helps me keep my car running. They're tremendous people. I get calls from my friends while they're on the service line or on the floor buying a car all the time. It's great. Why do people go to Warren Henry? Well, by now you know that when you're looking to buy or lease a car, we all know you want to get every advantage that you can. That's why if you check out Warren Henry, Land Rover, Range Rover, Infiniti, and Jaguar up at 151st and Biscayne, up in Gainesville, they sell Audis, down in the Keys. Well, they've got all kinds of great cars down there. So no matter what kind of car you want, they're going to be able to help you get it. What do all those cars have in common? Well, they're all great cars. They all come with the Warren Henry Advantage. What's that? That's a long list of services you get. It starts out with a free service loaner if you need to leave your car. Goes all the way through. They'll polish up your rims. If you scratch them, they'll give you a new key. If you lose your key, those are expensive. My wife, they treat her like gold over there. My mom, too, in the service line. And they'll guarantee you're getting the best price on your used car, on your new car. And of course, they got the 72-hour exchange guarantee. If you don't like your car, you can exchange it. But nobody ever does that. They love those cars. They're great cars. So join me, beautiful wife Vivian, my mom, lots and lots of my friends. I've even gotten texts during the show about, hey, how do I get a hold of Larry's in right now? I need a new car. So always, Warren Henry.
Carlson from Carlson Integrated. You know, a lot of our clients find that they can do anything, but not really everything. And we are always excited to jump in and help. So whether you need another set of hands for a project or even comprehensive marketing management, our team of marketing mavens would love to have a conversation with you to see if we are the right fit. We do everything from logo and design work to email outreach and social media to writing and thought leadership. And here's a fun one. We are now offering our fabulous ebook of top 10 marketing tips on our website for free. So head over to carlsonintegrated.com and grab a copy today. And please always let us know how we can help. My email is Becca, that's B-E-K-A-H at carlsonintegrated.com. That's B-E-K-A-H at carlsonintegrated.com.
Hey, this is Jim Freed. First of all, those folks at Carlson Integrated are tremendous. They do just a great job for me and my clients. And hey, give me a call. I work with a lot of families, families from Florida, families from overseas, families from Israel, families from Latin America. I work with a lot of real estate operating companies, big names that you'd recognize and names that you might not recognize. But in all cases, I help them evaluate their real estate opportunities. I bring them together. I help them look at things differently. And in some cases, I introduce them to people they may already know, but in a different way. What does all this have to do with you? Well, if you're working on a real estate transaction, just give me a call. I can help. I'll help you evaluate what's going on. And I bring a lot of gray hair and experience to the situation. Why would you want to reach out to me? Because if you do, it's always all about you.
Welcome back to Freedom Business. Connect with us on LinkedIn, YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter at Jim Fried or at Freedom Business, and on Instagram at Jim Fried One. Now, back to your host, Jim Fried.
All right, we're on with my, we're going to be bringing on my good friend, Jeff Glusman. Jeff is the Senior Investment Officer for ESOTERIC, an investment management firm that helps art collectors and art owners liquefy their investments. Welcome back to the show, Big Jeff. Where's Jeff? There he is. Jeff's coming on today as the voice only. Hey, Jeffrey, how are you?
I'm doing well, Jim. How are you, sir?
I'm doing fine. So let's talk about what's up with ESOTERIC. I know that you started the firm now about over a year ago. Let's talk about what's going on.
Well, we're coming into a soft launch period. We've got to the point where technology and fintech are all operating as they should be. And we've brought in considerable assets and are structuring good cash flow and liquidity events for our clients. So we're at the point where we're going to be going into a Reg A filing and entering into the public arena in the next 90 days or so.
Jeff, let's take a step back because I think that you went over something very fast. It's actually extraordinarily fascinating. You know, I'm down here in Miami. It's the middle of summer. We've got four months till Art Basel.
Sure.
And Art Basel, the entire universe descends on Miami in their private jets to buy art. And then they leave with art. Usually they buy the art, I don't know, cash, all cash, partial cash. And, you know, some of the investors hold it for a long time. But after a while, they may want to pull some cash out. I've gotten calls from different people that have art that need loans, and I put them in touch with you. What's the process and what can you do?
Well, the process is what's important. A lot of people that have bought art and have seen it appreciate or inherited art to certain levels don't have the ability to get loans from the large institutions because they don't have the assets on deposit. So we have the ability, based on our asset base and our relationships with the institutions and boutique lenders, to create an opportunity for people to have that access. The idea of being house rich and cash poor, a lot of people are art rich and cash poor and are looking for liquidity, especially in times like these where you see equity markets correct or we're in interest rate pressure on the real estate market, for instance.
Yeah, you know, we're going to talk to Ed Cairo in the second half of the hour, but it's basically the same concept. All cash assets, assets that are owned all cash or with low leverage, you come in. And some of the terms that we've used in the past that are quite interesting, but not everyday terms like Provençal or Provençal. Talk to me a little bit about how people prove that they own this art and what it is.
Right. So the provenance and the catalog resume, the provenance is showing where the art started from the artist's hand to where it is currently. So if Picasso did a painting and sold it to John and John sold it to Steve and Steve sold it to Jim, then you should be able to show the hands that it changed, the time that it changed and who the owners were. That proves, along with the bill of sale, that you are the accurate and correct owner of the art. And the catalog resume is basically a confirmation that the art was done by the artists in, just like it says, a catalog, a formal catalog. Artists like Picasso have tens of thousands of drawings, so you have to get into what's called the versus, and it's very significant, and some catalogs are much smaller. But those two components are extremely important in due diligence and qualifying and authenticating the art, which is by far the most important step that we take in controlling risk.
It's fascinating how you describe all that, because what it really sounded like, it sounded like a real estate deal. We were talking about the chain of title, mm-hmm. and I'm interested to wonder, when is all this going to go on the blockchain? Listen to me just blending all of my little speeches together. Right, Jeff, well, is blockchain coming to this?
I think it's already here. I think what you've seen happen in the art space over the last 5 or 6 years, pressed by Gen Z and millennials and their interests, obviously the NFT space, the hedges of the world, you know, Bitcoin or digital coin have kind of fallen off where art hasn't, but there is definitely an evolution in that space, I think is the right word to use.
Well, the difference, and you nailed it, is that you talked about and compared it to the cryptocurrencies. Art is an asset-based asset. It's an asset. It's a hard asset. So yep. Literally, if they were going to do something down the road, and maybe this is a topic for another show, they could literally tokenize it and split it up and have multiple people owning the art. I can't believe
That exists already. You can go to Masterworks. They're not true competitors of ours, but there are a lot of businesses in the art space that provide an opportunity for you to own, let's say, a part of a Picasso, a percentage of, and as an investment over time.
Wow.
Art is truly, if you think about who owns expensive art, and typically it is the high net worth individual, when there are pullbacks in the economy or recessions, if you will, they don't sell their art, they hold it. And that provides the stability and a hedge in periods like we're in now, periods of inflation or volatile markets that make it such an interesting asset class.
Yeah, and like you said earlier, somebody can be art rich and cash poor, just the way that they're house rich and cash poor. It's a fascinating idea. Now, Jeff, we're going to go to a break.
Sure.
And then when we come back, if you could talk about some of the masterpieces that you've worked with and describe the type of collectors and art owners you work with, we'd really like to hear more about that. We'll be right back with Jeff Glusman, the Chief Investment Officer for ESOTERIC LLC, the art investor. More after this. Well, I want to make sure everybody knows about my friends at Warren Henry. Larry Zinn is tremendous. Ismet, can't forget Ismet. All my friends over at Warren Henry, they're tremendous. Remember, when you're looking to buy or lease a car, you want to get every advantage that you can. That's why you check out Warren Henry Land Rover, Range Rover, Infiniti, and Jaguar. They're up at 151st in Biscayne. In Gainesville, they sell Audi. Down in the Keys, they sell them all. What do they all have in common? Well, they're all great cars, and they all come with the Warren Henry Advantage. It's a long list of services they get when you buy your car. It includes, of course, complimentary service loaner, key replacement if you lose your fancy keys. If you mess up your rims, they'll help you out by polishing them up and making them look good again. They'll guarantee you the best price on your used car, on your new car, and, of course, they'll give you 3 days to make sure you love that new car. Guess what? Nobody ever turns those cars back. They love them. So join my beautiful wife. She just got the brand new QX60. It's amazing. Me, my mom, we're all members of the Warren Henry family. Lots of my friends are too. You should be a member of the Warren Henry family. Remember, always the best price, always the best service, always Warren Henry.
Can AI supercharge your real estate analysts? With DeepLocks, you can now canvas entire cities in minutes. Search by total buildable, potential units, and uses allowed. Now live in 100 cities. Book a private demo and supercharge your real estate analysts. DeepLocks.com/demo.
I love DeepLocks. I use it all the time. I'm reticent sometimes to put it up there and advertise it because I don't want the competitors to get it. But Olivia is a tremendous friend. Her teammates and investors at DeepLocks are all good friends. And they do a great job, a great product. And Olivia will be back on the show probably in September, futuring out the world with us again. She's out there building deep blocks and working with some of the people that we've introduced her to. Remember, that's an example. That's what I do. I introduce different people to each other. Families work with me to get traction on the ground. Everybody, I got overseas family. I'll give you an example. I have a family, they're from Israel. They have a young son that moved over here. He's probably 25 years old, bought his first deal, all cash, leased it up, fixed it up, brought it to me. Actually through a referral. Thank you to the referrer. Thank you for the referral. Everything's a referral these days. And we're helping him build his bank relationship, pull some cash back out of that deal, and then help him get financed again on his next deal. Why is that important to you? Well, I can help you too. I've been through it all. I've seen it all. You hear Jeff talking about the fact that we're entering into another change in the economic cycle. I know what to expect. I know that you need to remain flexible. I know who to call depending on what issues are going on your real estate. So please just reach out to me, because there's something that's in common with all my clients. They all learn it real fast. And that's when you call me, it's always all about you.
Welcome back to Freed on Business. Connect with us on LinkedIn, YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter at Jim Freed or at Freed on Business, and on Instagram at Jim Freed One. Now, back to your host, Jim Freed.
All right, we're back. My phone is popping. My deals are hopping. And I actually have some new leads that are coming in while we're talking. So, boy, oh, boy, it's hot out there. We're back with Jeff Glusman. Jeff is an old friend. Welcome back to the show, Jeff. Miss you a lot. Wish we had the picture, but I'll see you soon enough, I hope.
Yes, sir.
So, Jeff, we were talking about esoteric. Let's just go through the quick rundown. Basically, you're an art-focused fund that helps people liquefy their investments in art to pull cash out of the house. Out of the art, it's like being art rich and cash poor. Let's talk a little bit about the quality of art that you make your loans on and who some of the clients that you make loans for are.
Sure. Well, the quality of the art, and we've got a rigorous due diligence process, and this isn't something that we came up with on our own. We've looked at a lot of different major institutions. You know, Merrill Lynch Capgemini comes out with a World Wealth Report every year, Citigroup, Deloitte comes out with an art and finance report. So we have an opportunity to use those reports along with what's available to us digitally, like ArtNet, the Art Confidence Index, to find which artists are moving up and down. While an artist like Picasso, there may be a finite amount of art available, right? They're not making any more Picassos. However, you'd be surprised to know that his ranking, if you will, as an artist has dropped down significantly over the past 5 years. So sometimes we know names of artists, but they're not the artists that are necessarily rising in values. For instance, the last few years, there's been a lot of attention to the Frida Kahlo, Diego Rivera combination of Mexican artists. And we've seen records set, you know, $30, $40 million, $10, $15 million sales, where no one really had heard about them at large. We weren't taught about Mexican artists when we were kids, right? We heard about Picasso, but we didn't hear about Rivera. So we are following trends like that. And we're also having to follow trends of smaller artists and minority artists that are finding their way onto the scene that in the past hadn't. And I'm not talking about the Basquiats of the world. But what we have to be careful of in that process are the fake fraud efforts that are put out in this space. And it is disappointing how many people are out there on a daily that you read about trying to put off fake art.
So, well, you wrote about that in the art gallery in Palm Beach County. Just the guy just got busted a couple of weeks ago.
Yes, sir. And up in Orlando and up in New York. And I think, you know, the biggest focus there is using the right appraisers, using the right authentication partners that have a reputation for identifying fake art. It's not so much important to get everything authenticated. It's to make sure that when you're saying something is in fact what it is, that you've got the support, not just the provenance, not just the catalog resume, not just the bill of sale, but up-to-date certifications. Got to have the right curator look at the work and make sure that it's conserved so that when it's sold or when it's auctioned or when we lever it, it's of the status that it should be.
Now, Jeff, that kind of brings up an interesting point. When you make the loan on the piece of art, does the artwork stay on the person's wall? Does it go to a vault? Do you need to have special insurance? What's up with that?
Sure. So that we do insure all the pieces as we go through the process. That's, I would say, step 4 or 5, if you will, in what we call the cementing period. So after the appraisals, after looking at the provenance and the catalog, we go ahead and bind insurance. Clients have a choice. Art predominantly sits in secure storage when you're dealing with the big institutions like the Merrill Lynch, Morgan Stanley, HSBCs. But we do provide the opportunity for the client to have the art hanging in their house. So they have the opportunity emotionally to still enjoy the work, whether it was theirs that they purchased or that they inherited it, but still have that liquidity event and cash flow combination. So that is what separates us from the small amount of competition out there, is that we do have the private banks and the ability to do the loans ourselves, to warehouse the loans and allow the owner to keep the art in their homes.
Now, Jeff, and thanks again, Jeff. We were on with Jeffrey Glusman. He's the CIO of ESOTERIC LLC, the art investor. They help folks that are art rich to liquefy their investments. Jeff, what about the NFT world? We've seen that the crypto assets in the cash world have had a very dramatic run up and down. We've seen the NFT world go liquid and then illiquid. How does somebody know they've got an NFT that's truly quality, that will appreciate, rather than one that's simply being bid up by, a pump and dump scheme?
That's a great question. I hate to say, hey, there's a great piece of land in the Everglades, and plenty of people bought that land without actually visiting the Everglades, right?
Yeah, they got a toaster, Jeff, for the ride out there.
Right, that's right, or the Brooklyn Bridge idea. So I think the NFT space is a moving target. It's driven a lot more by that emotional quotient component we spoke about, right? The desire to have something that maybe others can't get, or to get a piece of something that is highly sought after. We are seeing a lot of trend in that space, and we have spoken to artists to sign with us exclusively to work with them on their pieces for real, if you will, functional art as well as NFT. However, I would say that we're probably on the 90 to 95% focused on, old masters, on classic art, and we're going to let the NFT space like water kind of settle to its level and then tiptoe in.
Jeff, I want to go back to something that you mentioned before, which was very surprising, at least to somebody who is, we'll just say, over 45, that the classic artists are not as in much demand. And I would think that Renaissance versus early 20th century versus something we might see Warhol-ish in the middle last century, those are three different genres. Are they all slowing down, with the focus being on more modern, or I'll even say this, more reflective of the diversity of the American investor class these days?
I think so. I think that the diversity of the investor class really should be speaking to the youth that's been investing in art. A lot of people think of art as the old stuffy, snobby, club folks that own the expensive art, where really it has been the younger generation the last 5 years that have been most active in identifying and pushing the space. So
that's fascinating.
It is.
Why do you think that trend has occurred, Jeff?
I'm smiling. I'll be celebrating a birthday next month, and pretty close to half a century. And I'm smiling and shaking my head and saying, I wish that, the Gen Xers, that my generation would have been a little more aware and astute in our early 20s, much like the idea of buy a good piece of land and hold it for 20 years, right? If we would have bought in Jupiter 30 years ago and sat about on our rotted on it, we would have done okay. And I think that the younger investor in the art space, I think they see the value, and they also want what they like. They don't want what people are dictating to them. They actually want what they like, and then they go get it. And I think that's different than the way we were at that age.
Jeff, we're running out of time. So what are some artists that we should keep our eye on moving forward?
I think you've got to do, you know, just like what most people would, you've got to consider the classics. The Dutch Masters are really a space that we like a lot. But we've seen such a push on little known artists lately becoming big. And I also offer up to you that unfortunately we're losing a lot of great artists and a lot of great collectors that have hit their late 80s and 90s. And as they're passing, I think, and everyone knows this, right? If an artist passes, then certainly the value goes up, right? They're not making any more. So we're still keeping our eye on the aged artists. And we're also looking for the newcomers. There've been some amazing artists that are in their teens that have shown up on the scene recently. So trying to keep our perspective open on that.
Can you give us a couple of names of people to watch?
I would still focus, I mentioned before, on the Diego Rivera. I don't think that his paintings have ascended to where they will go. I think his name will end up being lockstep with the Picassos of the world. And he'll stand there as the male Mexican artist, and Frida obviously killing him as far as the values that she sold. And I would also just be aware that when you're hearing about people finding, 10 and 15 and 20 paintings in their basement, probably not real art.
Jeff, I want to thank you so much for coming with not only great information, but your wry sense of humor, which I totally enjoy. Thank you so much for being on the show. I look forward to having you guys back again, hopefully maybe a little bit after Labor Day as you move forward with your business plan.
We would love to do that. And I'm going to try to get out of here and see my 15-year-old. It's his birthday today. So give Judah Glusman a little shout out at the end here. And Jim, thank you. You know, the opportunity to speak to you the way that you can effectively compare what you've done in real estate for all these years. And as a mentor of mine at Grubb & Ellis, the good side of 25 years ago, I really appreciate the opportunity to come on the show. And thank you, Reagan, for helping out as well, as always.
Hey, we really appreciate you. Happy birthday, Judah. Get out of here. Family time is the number one thing that we like to emphasize here. Jeff Glusman, thank you so much. It's been my pleasure to be your friend and mentor for 25 plus years, Jeff. You make me smile and feel great. You're the
best. Thanks, Jim. Have a great day.
You too, Jeffrey. We'll be back after this with somebody who mentors me in the real estate space, Ed Cairo. He's the man who's taught me the residential home loan space. There's all kinds of new products, but actually it's a flashback to the past. A lot of things that are going on today are things that Ed and I used 20, 25 years ago, actually 30, when rates were up this high before. So stick with us. We're going to tell you how you can buy your house and pay down your credit cards with Ed Cairo right after this message. Mr. Mendoza, take it away. You know, I look at those aerials, it makes me feel so great because I'm doing more. Oh, it's so wonderful to help change the face of South Florida. And I'm going to tell you somebody else who changes the face of South Florida in so many ways. That's the folks at Warren Henry. Every year they have a Athlete of the Year award that they give out. Last year we were there for the award. We interviewed the award winner and Lewis Oliver. They talked about the fact that you have to always be persistent. Well, the folks at Warren Henry are always persistent. They're very consistent, persistent and consistent. I like that. So when you're looking to buy or lease a car, you want to get every advantage that you can. We all know that. That's why you have to check out Warren Henry. Land Rover, Range Rover, Infiniti, and Jaguar up at 151st and Biscayne. In Gainesville, they sell Audi. Down in the Keys, they've got all kinds of great nameplates down there. What do all those cars have in common? They're all great cars, and they all come with Warren Henry Advantage. That's a great list of services that you get when you buy. You get they'll polish up your rims if you scratch them. If you lose your keys, they'll replace them, those fancy automatic keys. They'll guarantee you're getting a great price on the lease, on the sale, and they'll make sure that if you don't like the car, you get 3 days to return it. But nobody ever does that because these are great cars. So join my beautiful wife, Vivian. She just got the brand new QX60. So Vivian, my mom, she's got one of these gorgeous Infiniti cars. I have one too. Lots and lots of my friends In fact, somebody called me on the show last week when they were sitting in the service line a couple of weeks ago. Somebody called me and asked for Larry's direct line so they could buy a car, which I gave him. Larry responded right away. So remember, always Warren Henry.
Becca Carlson from Carlson Integrated. You know, a lot of our clients find that they can do anything, but not really everything. We are always excited to jump in and help. So whether you need another set of hands for a project or even comprehensive marketing management, our team of marketing mavens would love to have a conversation with you to see if we are the right fit. We do everything from logo and design work to email outreach and social media to writing and thought leadership. And here's a fun one. We are now offering our fabulous ebook of top 10 marketing tips on our website for free. So head over to carlsonintegrated.com and grab a copy today. And please always let us know how we can help. My email is Becca, that's B-E-K-A-H at carlsonintegrated.com. That's B-E-K-A-H at carlsonintegrated.com.
You know, Carlson Integrated, Rebecca and her team, they always help me look good. We know that's not easy, but they do it. They've helped a lot of my clients too. They do marketing brochures, they do e-blasts, they do all the stuff. And she's so right. I think I can do everything myself. I can't. I have a tremendous team that she heads up on the marketing side, and that Riggs Mendoza heads up on the production side. Mr. Mendoza and I are going to look at some new things with some of my other teammates and see what we can do. New ideas coming soon. Hey, but I work with families from all over the world to help them execute their real estate deals all over South Florida. In fact, I had a family from Latin America ask me if I could do loans for them in small cities across the southeastern United States. I said, sure, we're going to be talking later this week. I've got another group that's from Latin America that's coming up. They want to build some housing. I'm going to help them do that. I have a group from Israel. They're buying cash flowing real estate. I'm helping their son build his credit down here and meet the right bankers. So what am I really doing? Well, you know, by now I'm executing my personal business plan and I'm being true to my brand. My brand is that I self-actualize by helping other people achieve their dreams and goals. Call me so I can do the same for you. Why? Because when you call me, it's always all about you.
Welcome back to Freedom Business. Connect with us on LinkedIn, YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter at Jim Fried or at Freedom Business, and on Instagram at Jim Fried One. Now, back to your host, Jim Fried.
All right. Jeff Glusman set the tone earlier today. He talked about how he can help you pull money out of your artwork. We're going to talk about how you can pull money out of your home right now. Hey, Eddie, where's my man, Ed Cairo, my brother, Ed Cairo? There he is.
Hey, Jim,
Ed, look at you with the fancy background. Your brothers must have done that.
Of course they did.
So, Ed, listen, we were talking with the guy, with Jeff in the first half of the show about pulling money out of your house. I mean, pulling money out of your artwork. People are talking about how high interest rates are for their homes, and they are relatively high based on the last 2 years or 10 years or when they were putting and driving cost of money down. But over a 30-year period, we're still at historically low rates. And hey, if you compare this to somebody's credit card, I think we win on that one every time.
Absolutely.
So I got to believe that a lot of the loans you're doing right now are helping people pay down credit cards. What's going on?
Well, that's exactly right. I mean, I think people now are having a tough time with a lot of the gas prices and food prices and so on and so forth. And the cash flow has been compromised. So people are definitely using their credit cards more than they did before. And as the credit card balances go up, I mean, those percentages are pretty high. So we've got a couple of products that are just starting to come out now where the HELOC products, which are equity lines, and they seem to be doing pretty well.
Now, right when the mortgage rates went up, and they've gone up about 150 basis points in just the last 2 months, that's a lot.
Yeah.
That's like from 3.5 to 5+. Mm-hmm. You know, we were talking to people, they wanted to do cash out, refis, pull cash out, but they had a problem. They were gun shy in the interest rate. So there's a way to get the interest rate lower today. In fact, there's a variety of ways. What are some of the things that you're doing to do that? And Ed, I think that the real thing that we're trying to point out here is that at this point in the market, it's really important to have a professional guiding you through the process.
Yes, it is. And you know, the interest rates are what they are. There's nothing anybody can do about them. And where they're going to go in the future, none of us really know. But the bottom line is that people will continually buy homes and people need financing, you know, and if that is the case, there's ways that we help them in that respect. One way is these equity lines in tandem with their first mortgages, you know, instead of jumping into the jumbo market, let's say, we can do a conventional conforming loan and then back it up with a simultaneous equity line at the same time, which, you know, will lower their effective borrowing rate. The equity lines are good because they have a line of credit they can use. If they pay it down, they can still keep that equity line and utilize it in the future. And for some people, that works out pretty well. The other part is really, you know, paying off all the debt, because when they look at the credit cards, these are 30-year payments, you know, and the minimum payment on a credit card can be in 20-25%, or whatever the case may be, where these equity lines are coming in the 6s and 7s% wise. And those are, you know, truly a lot better, and the payments are a lot lower.
I want to talk about one of the loans that we recently did, Eddie. You know, it was referred to me by somebody from out of town. The loan was actually for a couple up in Tampa. Mm-hmm. We won't talk loan amount or property type. We'll talk in general. And interest rates started to go up. And they got cold feet. They didn't want to get involved. They said, we'll back off. And you got them on the phone. And you did just a simple ledger. All you did was you took their credit cards, mm-hmm, and the increase in mortgage payment, because we were going to give them a loan that was a little bit higher rate than the loan they had before. Mm-hmm. And tell me what you found when you showed them the difference.
Well, I mean, you know, a lot of this really has to do with the cash flow. I mean, it's really about cash flow nowadays. And I think that's where people are suffering. So, you know, people are very shy right now because the first thing that they say in their head is, oh, well, you know, rate's a little bit higher than I want it to be, or I want it to be at this number or less. I mean, these are numbers that they're coming up with out of the blue. But the reality is, I mean, if their overall payments, just to give you a quick example, of, you know, $5,000 a month, and we can structure a loan where we take some of the equity that's in their house, and let's face it, in Florida, I mean, the houses have been appreciating quite a bit. So there's quite a bit of equity in the properties. So if we can, you know, just refinance them, regardless of what the interest rate is, when you look at the overall payment from a cash flow standpoint, you know, they'll save $1,500 a month, $1,000 a month, $2,000 a month. That's significant. It really is significant. And what I always tell a lot of the clients is that if they did do that, take the payment that they were paying before and start banging down that equity line or the first mortgage or whichever way we structure it. So before you know it, they're out of debt quickly, very quickly.
Yeah. Well, what you're doing is you're taking a global look at them. Most people don't think about themselves globally. They sit, mm-hmm, there at their desk on the first of the month and they just pay all their bills, put them in an envelope, or I guess now go online and click through, and then they just forget about it. They don't realize that there's incredible cash management opportunities just utilizing your home and some of the other assets like we talked about earlier, artwork. So this is really today's episode is really about cash management,
yes,
and maximizing limiting your cost of capital. And that's what we're really talking about here.
That's what we're talking about, Jim. You're absolutely right. And people have to understand too, that, you know, nobody can predict what the future is going to be. What they can control is their cash flow. And I don't care who you are, what age you are, you know, cash flow is always an issue. And if it's a good solid cash flow and you're comfortable, that's one thing. If it's a little bit compromised, I mean, you really need to do something about it. And you really can, even if they think they don't qualify because they have too much debt, we're basically paying off a lot of that debt, which will help them qualify too. So we structure these loans in such a way that their overall payment is a lot less and they can breathe a little bit in this current situation.
I'm making notes. So Ed, what do people say when you tell them this? Cause they all come to you. It's like right now, it's like going to the executioner. You know, I got my house. I love my house. what am I going to have to pay for my house? And they're going, oh my God, my friend just told me he just paid 5%, 3% a couple of months ago. I went to his house. He listened to Ed Cairo, who got him that loan. He stapled the mortgage quote to his front door so we never forget what a great deal we got him. And now the friend walks in and he can't get that 3. He has to get a 5. How do you make that guy feel better, Ed?
Well, again, you know, if it's a refinance situation, we will definitely look over their whole portfolio and see exactly what they're paying out. And if we could structure a loan, I mean, the interest rate in a lot of cases, you know, really is insignificant if it's a point or two higher than what their friend, let's say, had, as long as we can take their overall payments and lower them so they can save some money or, you know, accelerate their payment. Because the key would be to, especially in this environment, to have as least amount of debt as possible. Unfortunately, people are piling up the debt right now. So we want to reverse that trend. And if we put them into something that, you know, they can have some extra cash flow, they can then utilize that cash flow to pay down their debt at an accelerated rate, which is the goal.
I really appreciate all that, Ed. Ed, we've got a break coming up. Would you like to stay on and talk more residential mortgage?
Sure, I'd love to.
All right, great. Mr. Mendoza, this is your part of the show. Great show we're having today. I'm so great. It's so wonderful. Jeff Glusman, one of the guys that I've mentored for years, and Ed Cairo, one of the guys that mentors me. You see how the world kind of goes around? And the other thing is that you can't have an ego. You have to always be ready to learn. I love Ed. Ed teaches me all this great stuff. He's been around for 30 years in that resi mortgage business. Ed, we got to get you an ad on this show. I'm going to write that down. Mr. Mendoza, put that on your checklist. All right. Now, if you're looking to buy or lease a car, you want to get every advantage that you can. First of all, thank you to Warren Henry. They've been a sponsor for over a decade. This month marks the beginning of our 11th year with Warren Henry as a sponsor. It's tremendous for us because it endorses the show. It's just that they've been here that long. It shows that you, our listeners, really patronize Warren Henry. We want to thank you for that. We want to thank you for supporting the show and supporting Warren Henry. Now I'm going to go into the Warren Henry thing again. Now, if you're looking to buy or lease a car, you want to get every advantage that you can. That's why you have to check out Warren Henry Land Rover, Range Rover, Infiniti, and Jaguar up at 151st in Biscayne. I love that place. Up in Gainesville, they sell Audis up on Main Street up there. It's a gorgeous facility. You've got the coolest cars up there. Down in the Keys, they sell all their nameplates down there. You can go down there and get your pickup truck, whatever you like. And remember, what do they all have in common? They're all great cars. And they all come with the Warren Henry Advantage. And that's a long list of services that you get from them. They keep updating it all the time. Right now, it includes loaner car, if your car stays in for service. I've used that before. They'll polish up your rims if you scrape up your rims. I'm a close parker, so that happens to me all the time. I've lost my keys. They've helped me. Those keys cost a lot of money to replace them. They replace them for free. They'll guarantee you're getting a great price on your used car that you're selling. They'll guarantee you're getting a great price on a new car that you're buying. And they'll guarantee that if you don't like the car, you get 3 days to return it. Guess what? Nobody really returns it because they love those cars. They're amazing. I've owned an Infiniti for like 1990. Wow, that's a long time. So remember, join me, my beautiful wife, Vivian, and my mom. We're all members of the Warren Henry family. Lots of my friends are too. You should join us. And remember, always the best price, always the best service, always Warren Henry.
It's time to stop the hate and spread some love. You are beautiful, you're smart, you are awesome, and you never have to change for anybody. You have the voice and you have the power. We are so much stronger when we come together. It's your choice, so choose to be inspired. Choose to be accepting, be strong, be brave. Be awesome. Be daring. Be kind. Choose kindness.
You know, I want to leverage off of what Carrie Underwood said. My brand is that I self-actualize by helping other people achieve their dreams and goals. I do that for people from all over the world. I kind of look back and it's really amazes me at my client base right now. Israel, Latin America, Europe, New Zealand. I forgot about New Zealand. Hey, Lindsay, high five, New Zealand. So I do deals with families that are based all over the world. We do the deals in South Florida mostly. Lindsay and I did our deal in Charlotte. Still haven't met Lindsay. Still haven't been to Charlotte. But my contacts came to play and we were able to close that great deal for Lindsay and his family. And we can do the same thing for you and your family. I'm helping a young man establish credit and buy properties here in South Florida. I'm helping another family enter the country and do some joint ventures to do developments of multifamily. I've got another young family that's starting out as real estate developers, and I'm teaming them up with one of the largest, most recognizable, in fact, two of the largest, most recognizable families in America. So if you're looking to effectuate a real estate transaction, you need a little help, a little guidance, maybe a little, well, I have it there too, but a little white hair. I've got the experience. Give me a call. And remember, whenever you call me, it's always all about you.
Welcome back to Freed on Business. Connect with us on LinkedIn, YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter at Jim Freed or at Freed on Business and on Instagram at Jim Freed One. Now, back to your host, Jim Freed.
I'm sitting here messaging Ed. Ed and I are going to get together after Labor Day and do some live shots for ads for Ed because I want Ed to have an ad the way Carlson Integrated does and Deep Blocks. Mr. Mendoza, where's Ed? There he is. There he is. It's my brother. So, Ed, you're the mortgage brothers. Tell me what that really means.
Well, what it means is we've got three brothers that are in our office here. One of which is my older brother, Paul, and he handles all the closings. My younger brother, Greg, he's got the processing part of the business. He's the middle part. And me, I'm meet, greet, and close. I'm the beginning. They talk to me, and I try to structure the loans and figure out all the different benefits for them and so on and so forth for the clients. So the three of us together are a team that is a well-oiled machine, and everything that comes in closes.
I love being part of that machine. People laugh when they go, hey, you're in the residential business. All you do is these big fancy condo buildings and apartment buildings and shopping centers. And I go, oh, yeah. But I know one thing. And they go, what? I go, Ed Cairo's cell phone number.
That's it.
You see, I'm the cousin. I'm the cousin. My job is to say, hi, I'm Jim. This is Ed. That's it. It's my whole job. And to make sure I don't violate the NMLS rules, of course. That's right. So listen, Ed, there's a whole bunch of sticking points here in South Florida. Let's go through them real quick. First, I want to talk about condos. Condos, are they financeable or not? Some are, some aren't. Tell me about that.
Some are, some aren't. It's going to depend on the way the management company runs the condo. But what I can tell you is that the ones that don't have the proper reserves, or there's too many investors, or some of these other issues that come up, we can do financing on those condos. If it's a primary residence, if they put 25% down, we waive the questionnaire so the bank doesn't even ask for any of those things. If it's an investment property or second home, then 30% down, same thing. So those are ways that we finance a lot of these condos for people.
Okay. People are in a hurry. They want to close fast, but the appraisers are slow and they're using historic data. How do you get past the problem of the appraisers today? Because the appraisers aren't current on the market. It's impossible.
No, they're not. And they're not current at all. And some of the ways we do it is, and part of it really depends on the deal, the client himself, the credit profile, and so on and so forth, how much money they're putting down. On a lot of these deals, we've been getting a lot of appraisal waivers, which, matter of fact, I have one right now in a building in Miami, 80% purchase, appraisal waiver. So there's no appraisal, there's no issues, nothing like that. You know, that's the way to go. Both clients are have very good credit scores, income, so on and so forth. the building itself must be recognized by Fannie or Freddie. So for whatever reason, we got a really nice appraisal waiver. I was clear to close on that particular property in about 7 or 8 days. I think it was 8 days.
Done. Now, Ed, we've seen deals where people go, well, I want to get this loan, but I haven't finished fixing the roof. Whoop, red flag. How do we handle that?
That is a red flag. And if there is an issue with the roof or any of those other things, we do renovation loans, you know, which are a little complicated sometimes. FHA has one, you know, Fannie and Freddie have them. That's the way you have to do it, because the lender will not, once it's revealed that there's issues with roofs and so on, obviously the lender's not going to lend until it's fixed. If you're purchasing a property, you're not going to be able to fix somebody else's property that you don't own. Some cases the seller, you know, refuses to do that. So that's the way we do it. We'll do a renovation loan, and then we'll, you know, we'll borrow extra money basically for the finished value, finished product, which would, in this case, let's say the roof is $25,000. We'll have an extra $25,000 funded, and then it goes in draws as the roof is repaired, and it's done that way. So that's one of the ways we do it.
Ed, one of the big issues here in Florida that doesn't appear to be going away anytime soon is property taxes. Property insurance. I said the wrong thing. Thinking about the right thing, said the wrong thing. Property insurance. Mm. You know, when you evaluate these loans, you do a cash flow on the borrower. With property tax in some cases almost doubling, what's the impact on the underwriters and the underwriting? Are they making you really go to town and focus and sharpen a pencil on what the person's ability to get a property tax is, you know, whether or not it's a hardened structure, stuff like that?
You know, the one thing I can tell you is that if somebody is purchasing a property, they're going to go by whatever the property taxes are right now, which is what the seller is paying for the remainder of the year until it gets reassessed, which is next year. And we all know that property taxes will increase. And we make sure we let the customer know that. They have to understand that. The insurance prices have been going up tremendously also. We have a ton of people that we deal with on the insurance side. So we'll actually shop it for them sometimes and give them a hand and see if we can't secure the best insurance we possibly can. But that's it's an issue. There's no question. Appraisals, taxes, insurance, those three.
I want to go back to something that you mentioned earlier. We kind of glossed over it. And that's people's credit. Okay. Today's economic environment, I think people are going to start to be like a Star Trek orbit, and they're going to start to deteriorate at a certain point and then start to go in and be eaten alive by the atmosphere there.
Right.
However, if they come to you, they can pull equity out and distribute it across their credit cards, pay them down or pay them off. I got to believe that helps with your negotiation with the credit bureaus and credit repair. Do you offer that capacity of service as well?
Absolutely. You know, and that's part of the service that we offer, because if they have, you know, more than 60-65% or so on their credit cards, their scores tend to go down. If they have less than 35%, they tend to go up. So a lot of times, if credit cards are maxed out, they're losing a lot of points in their scores. And the bottom line is that, you know, credit score, loan to value, affects their interest rate. You know, so if we can get the credit score as high as possible, then everything across the board, from buying cars at Warren Henry to wherever it is that they decide to purchase a home or whatever, credit cards also, they're going to get a better deal. So we take the relationship, we take some of the credit cards, and we try to get them down to a level where, you know, they're below those numbers that we talked about and hopefully paid off. And then their credit scores will tend to go up. I have a guy right now that we're closing today that had a $950 car payment. And his income was, you know, not a ton of money. I mean, he was, you know, having a tough time. And he was very bent on not paying off the car because he felt that, you know, I had another 5 years on it and I don't want to put it on my mortgage. And his mortgage amount was very low, had a lot of equity in his property. And when we kind of went through the numbers, he realized that, you know what, it's a $1,000 payment that we just eliminated for you. And, you know, he's closing today. He's thrilled. I mean, because, you know, you look at it as, you know, you don't want to put it on the house. I get it. But like we said before, if you have a little bit more cash flow, you can start to bang down those interest
rates.
Well,
that makes it tax friendly if he gets on his house payment.
Absolutely. You're writing off that interest where you're not doing it on the car. So there's definitely benefits to it. you know, you don't want to always do that, but that's why we do an analysis. We figure out what the best move would be, let's say, for the client.
Well, Ed, if people want to get a hold of you, how do they do that? Because we're going to wrap up the show here.
They can call us at 561-865-7488. And we're in Lake Worth Beach. We just moved to our new location, our new building, and we're doing a grand opening on this September 15th, ribbon cutting with the city of Lake Worth, which you're invited to, Jim.
Where's my invitation?
You didn't
brothers are out sleep on a job there.
You're coming.
All right. I'll be up there for that for sure. You know that, man.
Yes.
Listen,
yes.
I want to thank you so much for being here today. Ed Cairo, our mortgage expert for residential. I want to thank Jeff Glusman. I got to say it this way, our mortgage expert for artwork.
Yes.
I want to thank me, our mortgage expert for capital markets and residential with
Absolutely.
Ed. I want to thank Riggs Mendoza for putting the show together and Becca Carlson for helping us advertise it. I want to thank our friends at Warren Henry for paying for the show, for sponsoring us for 10 years plus. I love those people. Remember, we'll be on again next week. We've got a great topic that you'll enjoy that escapes me at the moment, but hey, I'm getting older. What am I going to say? But we do this. Why? We do this because I love it. And I get a great response from everybody I see too. They love this too, Ed. They do. They love you. I get great response from you, Ed. So remember, next week we'll be on at the same time. And you know by now, here it comes. The person that wants to do something finds a way. The other finds an excuse. Now go out there and make it happen. God bless you. And God bless the United States of America. Mr. Mendoza, the rest of the show is yours.